I'd ever call him a jazz dad.
Hey, I just realized we were all muted. Now we're unmuted. Ha ha, alright. Eh, you know, it's fine. Yeah,
the
jazz dad came well before a trash man, you know. That's just been a long running thing. But, you know, hey, fair enough. I mean, I think at this point I've definitely told him he's the trash man.
I mean, he's been excommunicated.
Yeah, as you said, we also don't talk so much, so, you know, hey, there you go.
Is there a Twitch that I should be connected to?
Yeah, I mean, the normal one.
Jeff, a ghost.
Yeah, the old standard one. There's no secret Twitch channel. Come on now. It's only one of them.
Listen. I just saw a Discord invite after I was... after I saw yet another failure to establish the Icelandic Socialist Party's ethics committee. Which is...
no ethics for you.
Well, okay, so... this was like the third meeting and the first one that I knew of because they neglected to update my email address in their system.
I saw that you finally got that resolved.
Yeah! they kind of sucked at it.
What? Suck at updating emails.
They don't have people
like?
On that. They don't have a staff that's like contacting people. They just have the one lady who's like, she's in her like 70s and she's doing a master's.
Oh, that's, I mean, you know, I was older and doing master's, you know, I can relate.
Listen, if you're doing a master's in your 40s, that's good. That's really cool. And I'm into it. If you're doing a master's in your 70s and also, like, a liaison for the communications of a political party, you've got to make a choice.
Yeah?
Also, apparently they got put into overdrive because, like, a higher up, he committed a MeToo-able offense.
Oh, that's interesting. Can you elaborate, or is it it's a little too private?
It's up there with the R word and everything.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and like I had genuinely forgotten that like I was in the shortlist to become part of the ethics committee.
Until, I didn't forget we got to fight a hunk, Joe. I hit the first one. I'm looking for another. Don't worry. I'll find you that hunky man. I'll find you a hunky man.
I demand hunk.
I'm working on it. Well, let's we'll steal us this bee here and work on the hunk hunt.
So, like, I got a call yesterday for a meeting that was happening today.
Mm-hmm.
I was not able to do my homework on this.
Oh.
I'm not sure if I want to be in this, especially when, like, half the, like, there's a...
Did I do all right?
There's a lady, like, this liaison saying, like, hey, maybe we don't want to kick out a guy for being a rapist.
Ooh, that's, yeah, I disagree. I'd say you'd want to kick somebody out for that, at the very least. And Joe, I found your hunk.
Oh, that's a bunk, a bee hunk. Oh, wait. All right. Hey, there he is. There's
that
boy.
That boy.
It's you know, really, really take him in. just those big googly eyes.
Yeah, that's the good stuff.
I'm afraid to know what's under that hood.
It's me, an entire me from head to toe.
Yeah.
Just like standing in the void that is covered up by the hood.
Well, since he's so hunky, I feel like, you know, you gotta use the sexy beam, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Hey. So I'm guessing that depends on the charm stat?
Yes. So Jade is our... Well, Sylvando a bit, but Jade is especially the give her all the charm. give all of the charm to her.
It's, also, it's... just gotta give a shout out to that animation where she's charging the sexy beam. Like, that's talent. That's like, it's classy. It's like ballroom, like southern ballroom dancing. It's really good.
Southern ballroom dancing.
Listen, there's competitive dancing that is performed here, and it's like there's Latin dancing, and it's just that. It's a lot of that. It's a lot of people being like classically horny to the beat.
I am aware that people often get horny to music. Yes, that's a thing I've heard of. You know.
That's why I used to go swing dancing. You know.
Oh yeah, but. Hey, I'm talking like no twerking, no daggering. It's just like a lot of movement of the hips. That's just like still like there's still two.
Is daggering the same as boner surfing? I'm just wondering adjacent. If that's like a geographical difference we got here.
Could be.
With me being in the States and you know you being in Scandinavia's.
Well, daggering is something that I heard of. Being in the States.
Oh. I mean, I also was an inside boy, so I mean, I very well could just not
yes.
do something. I don't want to blow your mind, but with, like, having, you know, the original Super Nintendo carts of, like, Earthbound and the Final Fantasies, but I didn't see a lot of sunlight, you know, if it wasn't baseball season. That was my outside time.
I could tell you, okay, so, skiing was my outside time.
Yeah.
But... yeah, I went to high school dances. There was not a single twerk happening, but it's like it was back in the day before.
Hey, Lobster Bowl, thank you.
Hey, back before the twerk was recognized. Like there were songs about twerking,
but
they spelled it TWURK.
Huh.
Yeah, that was the 90s.
Bam, bam.
Oh man, love this map. It's a good map.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, I had forgotten that we can just do the old quickie warp. There it is. This is where we want to go.
Yeah.
But, you know, I owed you that muscly man, so it was on purpose, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate it.
Hey, somebody's...
I appreciate this gift you've brought me.
I mean, I'm you know, even on my own day, you know, hey, I'll give a friend a muscly man to look at.
Gotta have it. It's your birthday?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Jeff.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry for not knowing it's your birthday. I'm gonna on my phone here.
The amount of times I make jokes about things, you know, on Twitter and whatnot. I mean, fair enough.
Man. Let's see. Gotta put in here. Does repeat every year.
It, I mean, you know, for a while at least. I got some more. Nope, I didn't want to forge.
Jeff. Ghost. B-Day. Save. There. Now I will always remember that you have a birthday.
I mean, we all have some manner of birthday. Guess.
Yeah.
Speak for yourself. I just manifested here.
Kind of cellularly divided and said, "Yep." You butted off enough, and you know you became a conscious entity.
Sometimes you gotta osmose your B day.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So we don't have birthday.
Oh, apparently it's Joy's birthday.
Oh, it's Joy's birthday?
I wished her happy birthday in the group chat.
Oh.
Hargle bargle.
You have a
casino, birthday. You got bunny girls, you're really, really getting our Dragon Quest in at this town. And
okay, my roommate also I'll says happy birthday. And apparently it is also his sister's birthday, so. See a man about, I guess she's in good company?
So Lando needs to go see a man about something.
What came over him all of a sudden?
Aw, I'm happy for
Lounging
him.
Off. So can we get, Healer Chick's outfit for Kung Fu Waifu?
Oh yeah, Rob and Sylvando, I believe, are the only people I don't have all of the outfits for. So yeah, we can change clothes.
As far as he's concerned, I'm just his old pal Rob. Let's keep it that way, all right?
Okay, Grandpa Uncle Scrooge.
That was from you last time. I haven't used it for anything.
All right, let's mix it up. All right, so you want to change Jade's outfit? Zell.
She's gone. Oh no.
Oh jeez.
What is it? Do you forget she ever said anything?
She said nothing. Nothing.
Ooh, we got a Xena.
Yeah. Which one? What do you want to throw in?
Oh, black cheerleader outfit. Let's do black cheerleader outfit.
The Metal Maniac?
No, there was a, that's like schoolgirl.
You're saying this one?
Yeah, there was a pink one, and then there was a black one.
This one.
No, it was like, okay, yeah, there you go.
The swimsuit?
Yes, black cheerleader outfit, there we go.
Okay, you know, fine, I see it as, you know, cheerleader shorts. Okay, fine, things are getting pervy. All right, fine, thanks. Not my
These
choice.
Are swim shorts.
Yeah.
Okay.
But also, bless you, Zell. You are braver than I.
Apparently,
look, I unlocked it.
Very
I'm
liberal high
too.
School, which was news to me, because that is absolutely what our cheerleaders wore.
I thought they did skirts. I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe the kick line, the drill team. Had those. Our cheerleaders had something a little more modest, but that is absolutely what I remember the lariats wearing. Except their skirts was less a skirt and more just tassels that were at the bottom hem of the onesie that they were wearing.
As a huge Stan Hansen fan, I love that your high school was the lariats.
We were the Coppell Cowboys.
Uh huh.
And so the drill team was the lariats. So.
I don't, you know, I'm into it. I'm here for it. Do we want to change out of the piglet? We got the kitties.
Why?
We got schoolgirl, you know. We got the weird angel, the pope thing, the raver, you know. Oh, it's Chad. Thank you, Chad.
I kind of really like the high priestess just because it makes her
the big dumb hat
appear. She has a height complex.
Yes, I love it.
Yes.
Birthday tomorrow for Chad. Look at this. It's like peas in a pod. All right. Still going. Emma Peel.
I really like that. It still doesn't reach the top of her staff.
I like the mischief maker there. That's
have
an entire team of schoolgirls. I didn't realize they all had the matching outfit.
Oh yeah,
that's
I've
a maid.
I'm
that's a
big
succubus maid.
Yeah, why not? Yeah. I'm a big fan of the entire team of schoolgirls. It's a good one. Let's see, we were doing our DQ8 dude before. Raid party. We're forced to wear this one later, so we're gonna save that. Raid participant. let's go with this one. You know, real classic Dragon Quest look for no reason at all. No reason at all. Ignore it.
Yeah.
No. Yep. None.
I'm a little saddened that he does not have the matching Japanese schoolboy outfit.
Yeah, definitely. I need him in like a Yankee outfit.
Yeah, I'd like him. Know? I'd like to be a hoodlum. You know, like we could see him in a Kunio game. I mean,
yes.
What the best we got is what the Cobblestone's Finest. I mean, even that's kind of a reach.
Give him a massive skullet.
Giant pompadour.
That's the thing. People keep calling it a pompadour.
He should have a weird speedo outfit. You know, I'm I'm tempted to get the windows port of this because I know people have made plenty of dumb outfits, and that could certainly be a gimmick that we have Team Speedo.
It definitely feels like there should be like a banana hammock situation, at least in one of those.
Silvando's still has to have the feathers, though.
Oh, yes. No, he needs a lot of flair on that thing. He's instructing the guards there in the if somebody could...
I do like that there's both an Italy and a Spain.
Well, I mean, they're very different, you know? Come on now.
They are. One has a bull, uh-huh. And one has cars named after those bulls.
Don Rodrigo will be sorry to have missed you too, señor. He often speaks of your visits.
So, when were you going to tell us that you're actually a VR tuber? Well, I'm
sure we'll have a you know, it's a project I've been working on for a while, and I just finally got it to work. You know, I just wanted to transcend my fleshy coil.
I love it so much.
Interesting topics of conversation. I had asked Charles her advice on getting it going, and finally found some stuff that worked, and somebody made this free little ghost, so I edited it a little bit, and I'm probably gonna tweak it a little bit more so it's like the other one. My old rainbow ghost. I really missed having the Bifrost on him. I'm gonna add that back in, but you know, hey, for now this works. Adding in the rainbows some math I didn't feel like doing today. All right, we can get to the open ocean.
I don't know. Does this thing not let you do like a for a loop through the HSV?
Do what now?
I figure if you somehow had access to the hue saturation, I forget what the V is.
Yeah, okay, I gotcha.
I don't actually know much about graphics.
Yeah, I mean, I'm...
anymore!
It's... Okay, so here's the thing, right? I'm old. I opened up the file, I started investigating, I found a ping, and I said, oh, this is just like making skins for Quake World! And that's how I was able to edit it, alright? Like, beyond that, it's... That's way above my skill level, and that's fine.
Oh man, remember when Photoshop came with, like, a rainbow gradient effect?
Maybe that's what I just like... need to do, use the rainbow gradient tool in this thing.
Yeah, why not?
Alright, let's start rocking in the free world. There's that gate. Alright, over this way. Camera.
I do like that you have a steamboat.
Yeah, I really like that they let you sprint with the boat, because I played a lot of Dragon Quest, so I've done a lot of sailing, and it's universally horrible.
It's a lot of freedom, but it also sucks.
Well, and in your classics, you know, they're not afraid to let you just trundle into getting your lunch handed to you. Mm-hmm. In the worst possible way.
I think that's actually where I stopped playing at 8, is we got a boat, and I needed to go somewhere, and then I put the game down for a while, and when I picked it back up, I no longer remember where I was supposed to go, and none of my party mates, like, every time I go somewhere, they're like, shouldn't we be doing something? And I'm like, yeah, you want to tell me what that is?
I've still just been working on trying to summon up the energy to sit through more of 6, because it's bad. It's not good.
Listen.
And my co-commentator Charles has been telling me just stop playing, and I said no. I can't let it win. I got to do this.
You have a goal.
Aw, he's so excited. Madre mía.
Is it? Him? Thump thump, thump thump, thump thump.
The one who makes my Kokoro go all doki doki. Oh man, look at that canyon. That's a good canyon.
Very nice.
It's a good canyon for speeding past.
I mean, you know, we can't really do anything in it yet, so, you know, I'm just, having a stroll on a ship.
Yeah.
I also like that, let's double check this. Now, I know Jade has high heels in everything, because, you know, models and whatnot. Yeah, okay, Veronica gets flats. Serena, close enough. Alright. Combat heels. Yeah.
Serena is keeping it classy. Like, she's got something to do, you know? She can't go out in heels just yet.
Got a little lift to it.
Ugh, where did all this horrible fog come from? I can't see a thing.
Hey, Sylph, what's going on?
Yo, Sylph, what's with all the fog?
But whatever it is, I don't like it.
Yeah, you got it, right? Mystified? You got it. It's good. It's good.
It's typed out. I don't think that's how you do in Myst.
No, you just you stop.
I can see light up ahead.
Is that how you stop? By just firmly spinning around the wheel of several rotations?
Yeah, pretty much. I also like that, you know, people who are riding Pine still get levels, because the party I have now is basically what I used for the entire game. You know, there's situational reasons you can cheese it with others, but, you know, eh.
Wait, does this mean that we finally... does this mean that Dragon Quest XI is secretly a Strand-type game?
Might be.
Can't believe there's a second entry in the genre.
A mysterious sandbar.
Alright, I'm back with a drink. What are we talking about now?
I was saying how I like that people who ride the Pine in this game still get levels because, you know, Triple Girl Team is pretty much what I stuck with when I was playing it. I didn't learn the situational quirks of Sylvando until subsequent ones.
What a strange place.
Which is ultimately, Veronica like never leaves. She's always there, because she's the win the game button.
Yep.
You have to make her angry, and she explodes, and then Sylvando gives her another turn, and she explodes again. It's great. I've waited for you
ever since the day. Oh, we're doing the mermaid thing now.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Well, we have to, because we just left the channel. They don't let us avoid this.
Hello, a mermaid. Sorry, we're not your husband.
And there's no need to look so disappointed to see us.
I like how pumped the ghost gets when I drink soda.
Maybe because you are.
I mean, I do love a good seltzer water.
Gasp, this woman that came out of the water, deep underwater, is part fish?
Maybe she was just, like, a really competent skin diver, okay? You don't know.
My name's Michelle.
You ever think about how there's just, women who have made a career out of just playing mermaid? For birthday parties and whatnot.
I'm talking to a real-life mermaid. But anyway,
I think there was something Midge and I were watching, like, about the, like, birthday princess industry, where it's, you know, legally distinct Elsa and Cinderella, so we don't get sued.
Yep. That's a real thing.
Your wedding day?
Apparently, the more advanced mermaids also employ a guy who, like, carry them around between pools.
At first, I was the same. I thought we'd never be together. I thought the mermaid's burden would keep.
You remember when the mermaid tail blanket thing was real big? I actually made one of those. It was pretty cool.
I
took for fucking ever, but
I don't. But I had a bunch of friends that were really excited when the Tauntaun sleeping bag thing became real. I couldn't.
come to live with him.
We run in different circles then.
Hey, you know, it's fine. Look, I've known a number of knitters over the years. It's just, you know, there's the ones that were the, they've made that hat, and you know what I mean? It's that hat that everyone who knits makes at some point. Some just only make it, others move on. And that I've known other knitters that will be able to knock out sweaters, you know, in an afternoon.
He's supposed to meet me here,
you know, just
so we can
broad range.
Together.
I can't knit.
And I've been waiting for him now for what feels like forever.
Oh, she's speaking and plugging
away at
my
Pokemon project.
Break his word. He's not that great sort of person.
But yeah, the yeah, the rhymes, because they're mermaids, they gotta... Mm-hmm.
Oh, I forgot they rhyme.
I know it's rude to ask you, but I beg, I plead, I pray. Could you go to Lona Lulu and make sure
so,
my Kai's
so, there's
okay?
A folk tale here of mermaid-adjacent people.
So you're from the bottom of the sea?
It's like...
Where the giant pearl from the story
guy
went.
Finds a girl... But, and he brings her home.
Aha! How about
but,
this? If we go
thing
and
is,
check on your
he
fiance,
found her at night.
You take us down
right
to see
by the
queen?
Right by the shore.
To pay for such a
turns
kindness,
out,
she's
actually,
do.
Like, a mer person.
Safely sink your ship and
but also,
your
like,
crew.
If
anyone knows the truth about
they
this
marry.
Pearl, it's the queen of the sea.
And they have 7 kids, and then, like, soon after, she just leaves, and, she, becomes a,
I had a sudden urge to stretch my legs.
Becomes a, merperson again. It's like a...
If anyone knows the truth about
because
the
she has
wrong
7 kids at sea,
if it leads us to another
and
one
7
yours,
kids
it's worth helping.
On land.
Say?
I mean, at least this is a pretty decent butt thou must. I kind of wish if you did it enough, she'd just clock you one. But we're in the loop.
If anyone knows the truth about this giant pearl, it's the queen of the sea.
Oh, I see. You have an opinion about not doing this quest. That deserves boot to the head.
Thank you.
And we're doing it. I'm your fake older sister. We're doing it. Get over yourself.
I'll mark the village on your map. It's to the south of Hotto. A beautiful blue bay behind an isolated grotto.
That's real good. It's real good.
Hanky, janky sailor stuffed
browning as hard as I can.
Mods, please rename me to a hunky chunky sailor.
Stuffed with smoldering emotion.
Just bring my darling back so we can finally be wed.
We're gonna find him, and he's gonna be either in a mental institution for telling people about her and they didn't believe him, or he's married and she was like a one-time fling of his.
Oh,
and he's
no.
Like, oh, oh
that
no.
Second one is very possible.
He's gonna be married with like 3 kids of his own, or it has not been established how long lived the mermaids are, so maybe he's been dead 100 years. We could probably find a descendant of his, right? Oh yeah, this is totally the guy you met before.
You think she might like just marry a corpse? You know, she marry a corpse.
Why don't we give her Eric?
Eric,
he's,
you know,
he's a hunky chunky sailor, right?
Eric gets situationally useful. You know, he can not as good as Veronica, but he can become a win the game button. You know, you can really min max a party with them if that's your style. Boomerang Eric, I messed around with my last playthrough, and I was really surprised at how much fun that was.
Well. I guess Eric does is full of smoldering emotion, but I don't know if he's
hey, you guys see them boats?
And or chunky.
I wouldn't call him chunky necessarily.
Yeah, it's the sticking point there, probably.
Alright, we made it. Fake Hawaii. Not an island, yeah. Though.
Nah, well, here's one thing about Fantasy Hawaii is that apparently most, if not all, of Final Fantasy IX is set in Fantasy Hawaii.
Huh.
Yeah.
I eat left such a bad taste in my mouth. That's where I stopped.
Yeah, eight is.
I'm getting them as they've been on sale on Steam, and I'm trying to. Want to see what my next paycheck is like before I pull the trigger on numbers 1 through 6 because they're on sale right now in Steam. But I have 7 through. I think 12. I forget.
I mean, I had all of the Game Boy Advance re-releases I had, and I enjoyed them, and I've seen the Pixel remasters, but I feel like at this point, just ROMs and randomizers or whatever, what I'm going to do if I'm going to play them.
I want to say 8 is definitely... 8 feels to me like they really wanted to make a saga game again, but give it a story.
Truly, darlings, this is the promised land.
About teens. And, like, if you want to make a saga game, then tell me it's a fucking saga game. Be fucking open about the notion that I should be actually avoiding battles.
Promising than I expected. Where is everybody?
Something's not right.
I remember this part of Tales
Still,
of the Abyss.
Not our
no, not Tales of the Abyss.
Let's
Tales
just
of Versaria.
Let's find this Kai guy and get out of here.
This Kai guy.
It's me. I'm the Kai guy.
Really? Because this Kai doesn't have any friends. You know, you seem like you got some friends.
Alright. Oh, man. This does feel like... relatable to 18-year-old me.
Guess what? We gotta go to church. His mom hangs out at the church.
Oh, wow. Oh.
Well, she's trying to have him exercised. Is that it?
Ooh.
Like, no local friends, but all of... and just a few online ones. I'm saying
look,
that the ocean is online.
The show's about to begin.
Oh man.
What is the kid on the right doing?
Are you all paying
attention?
What
into
was
it?
That?
Being excited about story time?
And I'll tell you the tale of the terrible curse.
You ever watched
Terrible Curse?
The curse of a crafty creature. With a face as pretty as a pearl, but a heart as black as coal.
Oh man, is this gonna be about mermaids?
I mean, you know, has a mermaid ever done anything for you?
The mermaid stole his heart and left him all alone. That's how mom is,
Once upon a time,
that's how mom's choosing to interpret it.
Lived in Lana Lulu.
Mom has issues with the mermaids, and that's fine.
Fish. And gathered more pearls than any of the other men in the village.
You remember,
the
Metalocalypse?
Mayor of Lana Lulu,
yes.
The big kahuna was very
remember how
fond of
they
this
just had,
fisherman, and
like,
offered him
a,
the hand
a one-off
of his
joke
beloved
about a song
daughter.
About mermaid murder called Mermaider.
The fisherman and the kahuna.
It's been a while, so sure.
Agreed to be married.
And you have triggered a memory in my roommate.
Looked bright.
Midge is a big Metalocalypse fan.
Oh, man.
Until the day of the storm.
Death Clock makes good tunes,
the
but Mervator is definitely,
a
like,
terrible tempest,
it's a bit on the rougher
and
side.
His catch were thrown into the ocean.
Because they had to have that mosh bit.
As he sank through the water... He saw the pearls
oh,
he
come
had
on,
gathered
Lobster, that's
shining
a different song.
Like stars
a very
all
good song,
him.
Mind you.
The light faded, and he prepared to
mermaid
meet
mermaid in the
his
water,
maker.
Mermaid murder. Okay, now I definitely remember that
instead,
one.
Instead, he met
thank you,
her.
Lobster Bro.
A mermaid.
Go into the water, live there, die there.
Creature
yeah.
he had seen before.
I think that's the final song on their first CD.
Whispered in his ear.
It's a good last song.
I will give you your life if you give me your soul.
Oh no!
Many days passed,
oh,
and
no!
the fisherman did not return. The people of the village thought him dead, and held a funeral for him on the beach.
So is this the story of Kai?
But just as they were
it would make sense for them to be telling the story about an NPC that we have no interaction with, so...
The Kahuna's daughter was overjoyed.
Giving me some story time in Super Mario Galaxy vibes.
Night and day, nursing him back to health. But the fisherman was no longer the man she knew. All day he would stare out to sea, muttering over and over.
Is that gonna be your new look? Just get a nice straw hat.
Mermaid. Then one
not
day
sure.
he threw his
fiancé
aside and ran to the harbor.
I've got mixed
screaming,
feelings about straw hats in general, just because I really dislike One Piece.
I wasn't even thinking about the One Piece.
He banished the fisherman from the village and burned his boat so he could never.
I've watched a few
technically
episodes.
That's a straw bucket hat, not a straw Panama hat. So.
I've watched a few One Pieces, and you know they're not bad. But then it's like, man, there's like 8,000 episodes. I don't. That's not a commitment I can make.
There literally is over 1,000 episodes.
Yeah, there's a lot to it.
But like, you watch the first few, and there's just like.
That's all for today, children.
So they did lock him away in an institution. Because
he just wanted a Pepsi, you know, just one Pepsi.
Mermaids are scary.
And she wouldn't give it to him.
Yeah, you know.
Steal our souls. Run!
He went to your schools.
He's
you know?
On drugs.
Fucking AMV hell fucked me up.
Right?
Maybe. We're looking for a fisherman called Kai. Do you know where we can find him?
I was in my
room.
To be
fair, I did track down and legitimately watch a lot of anime that I otherwise would not have if I had not seen the stupid clips in any of the various AMV hells, but...
What's that? I've never heard of an A-Ken. What are you talking about?
Along, maybe you could go lend a hand. Once that monster's dealt with, they'll all come back.
I always forget how long
sure
some
enough.
Of these cutscenes are when the Switch decides to go into, oh, you're not playing anymore, let's start dimming the lights mode.
Squid isn't the only danger out on the seas. Don't let a crafty
Don't
mermaid
let the mermaid make you all purple. Oh.
I'd hate to see you go crazy.
Nah, I'm reading that as purple.
Yeah, purple.
She's gonna take us down in the water and just choke us out.
There you go. Yeah, she's gonna keep you down there till you ain't alive no more, man.
The fucking symbolism of having her push that thing along like a baby stroller.
Right?
That's cinematography right there.
That's
how
art.
How do you tell us that she's this guy's mother without telling us that she's this guy's mother?
Mm-hmm. Or that she has like empty nest issues.
I thought these were destructible melons. No. Only the pumpkins.
0 out of 10.
You know, I'm revising. This is, you know, my upper echelon Dragon Quest. You know, since I can't destroy them melons. Being a jerk in people's houses is my favorite part of the game. Breaking all the pots, knocking the logs down.
Oh look,
wait,
it's
we're
a friend. It's Dave.
Are we not gonna go find the guy and take him with us?
No, we gotta sail west and meet up with those ships that we saw on the way in. Because apparently there's trouble with some sea creature, and you know we gotta help out because that's what Kai is.
Oh, and you know where it is, because there's boats.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they told us to get the fuck out earlier, because it's dangerous.
Yeah.
Here be dragons. We mark the dragons. We're here to tell you the dragons are here.
Did I do all right?
Great job, team.
Woo! Yeah.
I do like that Silvando, like, is designated.
Ooh, these must be the gallant squid hunters.
Designated wheelman. Husband to be.
Yeah, like he doesn't just own the boat; he knows how to drive the boat.
Excuse me, which one of you big brave?
You know, Jeff Bezos ain't driving that super yacht he owns, or you know.
Now I'm sure there's like some guy that's like controlling it by satellite.
I can't quite make it out. A good view. I love you.
The sailors are saying I love you.
If I had a nickel for every time I heard that from a sailor.
Oh.
Look out!
Oddly
there.
Enough, the image of sailors over here doesn't have any gay connotations. Oh, what the fuck?
Yeah, boat in the air, you know. It
boat
was like
to the face.
That whatchamacall, that Assassin's Creed game, right? Where the boats would just kinda clip into the air, right?
Now we have boot to the face before, and now we have boat to the face.
It's an ocean friend.
Oh, so friend-shaped.
Yeah. Look at that. He's got all these arms ready to hug you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, that's a cat.
What do we got here? We'll let Jade have a go. Backflip, no. Let's just go with the old multi-thrust. Nope, didn't like that. All right, you know, we'll buy some time.
Yes, it's real and it's tentacular.
Veronica's really angry. That'll work out fine for everybody, I'm sure. And let's just, you know, maybe make her faster for no reason. No reason at all.
Go for it.
So she can get angry more quickly. You just gave her a Twitter account is all.
Oh, no.
You gave the little girl a Twitter. You're right. All right, let's they said take care of the tentacles, fine.
Get up on the Hydra's back.
Attack its weak point for massive damage.
Feel the heat.
All right.
And where are we gonna get a pot of oil big enough to fry this sucker when we're done?
Right here. We're gonna just blow it all up real good, I think.
Nice. This is the
big one. Look at a fire magic. Anything can fry.
Oh, Veronica, I love you.
Thanks.
Easy peasy.
Little girl, just, you know, once again, you know, just took somebody out just on her own. It's fine.
Mm-hmm. Well, she did about half.
I'm pretty sure if you... I'm pretty sure if you let her just go with everything still up, she's got no problem knocking it out.
Lord.
Still stuck on there. Oh, all right.
No, he evaporated, you know, as they all do.
Oh, thank you! Darlings, it was not...
That looks like a pretty funky sailor.
Yeah!
Mahalo, mahalo. Whoever you people are, I can't thank you enough. But I can sure feed you enough. Tonight, we're gonna have a luau to remember, and you're gonna be the guests of honor.
Kind
of
like how this guy looks like how Don Morocco looks in current day. Who is a Hawaiian from Hawaii. So I'm into this. This is good. Never made that connection till now.
It's a respectable beard.
All right.
I saw that frame of your steamship accompanied by several sail ships.
Oh, and hey, metal.
I'm just thinking about there's a duck comic that's like that goes into the eruption at Krakatoa.
Mm-hmm.
And It's framed as a race away from the island. Between a steamship and a sailboat. At the sail... I think it's that, like...
I'm gonna say this lady's, talking about Sylvando, you know? It's pretty strong, you know?
Yeah.
Got a pretty face.
A real cutie pie.
I'd call Sylvando a cutie pie.
Although, you know, there is Dave, you know? Look at, he's, you know?
Yeah!
Dave's comfortable with himself, and I appreciate that about Dave.
I mean, he's dressed for the weather.
Yeah. Look, he works outside, you know? He just wants to be comfortable.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Knows how to handle his drink.
This guy's a little... Ooh, hey, and the nun, too. Wow. Whoa. Tashti beverages. So, you know, ghost facts. So Midge and I are not having children. And one of the reasons is I told her that, you know, I get bored easily and do dumb things. And I would speak to a child like this and pretend they were normal words. So, you know, That's why no ghost dad. Leave that to Cosby. Or don't, you know, just maybe pelt him with rocks. Hey, Savannah's got his hat on, all right, finally.
Yeah!
Love that hat.
Holy
look at this magnificent.
Good hat.
See, that is a magnificent outfit.
Yeah, like, you know, he's got his leather,
he's
but it's got flourishes.
He's making so many fabulous new friends. Go off, Sylvando. Live your best life.
Drinking him under the table. You must try the dry calamari. It was killed today, if you can believe it.
Okay. No Kai yet.
He's not much of a party person. Well, time to knock on every door.
Try the fresh mermaid. I mean, they probably would kill a mermaid
where
here.
Where do you think you're going?
Yeah.
Jana, just talk to you.
They kind of hate him.
You're off to look for Kai, aren't you? Well, I'm coming with you.
Quest?
Hi, Jade.
I think you've forgotten I'm a single-minded protagonist?
Those stupid fishermen.
Hi, Veronica.
Said the party was only for grown-ups, so they couldn't let me in. Is every barn...
Let's be fair here. Her body has been reverted. She should not be drinking.
But every bar is full of stubborn idiots, you know. I mean, even a cool bar is, you know, ultimately idiots. You know, you're knowingly killing yourself. And I say that as somebody who greatly enjoys his drink. We're all idiots at a bar.
I'm a little concerned that we're picking up party members for the seemingly simple task of finding a man in a peaceful village.
Well, don't worry. Everybody's still here. They're just, you know... On the map.
Yeah, but now we
things.
Have people with us in case of emergency.
Oh, hey, look, there's a line of men over here. Waiting on, Serena.
Serena, what you up to?
Let's see what these guys have. She's a... Oh, they're... Oh, my... Oh. Oh, oh.
Aww.
Oh, no, buddy. You know, you gotta... You know, you gotta communicate better, if you're unhappy in your relationship, good sir.
Yeah, communication is everything, my dude.
Yeah. I'm just trying to help these guys, and they just keep coming back with new injuries. It's the damnedest thing.
Hey, let's be fair here. Serena is a goddamn angel.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she's just pleasant to talk to.
Must stay away. Well, yeah, he realizes he shouldn't go to the bar and just get, you know, sloshed. Alright, look for Kai. Oh, we gotta do the map-a-do. Think we have to trip the flag first.
Gotta knock on some doors. Oh, look.
Now he's at the dock. Stuck on a rock. Alright.
Did he put in a sock? Guy.
I see him now.
He magically teleported there now that we know that's
Wait,
where
hang
he's
hang on, kitty.
It's this guy.
Of course.
Okay. Ew.
Hey.
So, do the cats meow in a regional dialect?
No, I think it's the generic cat sound.
Now,
you know, I've never not done it. Let's see what happens. Oh, you must be drunk. Okay. Yes.
So, what is supposed to be chunky about this guy?
Sorry, but I'm not.
Or
the
even
man
hunky.
Your story. You must have me.
I don't know. You know, everybody
else
appreciates different things.
Don't give us that nonsense. We know you're the only
guy,
and
I'm not shaming for it.
If you never meant to marry that
poor man, just saying she's inaccurate.
You should never have proposed to her.
Hey, go easy on the accusations, will you? People here got no love for mermaids. If they think I do, I'll be in trouble.
Then just fucking leave, my guy.
Kainoa, I take it you've heard the tale of the mermaid's curse.
Aha, knew it.
No.
Every kid in Lanalulu knows it by heart. The story of the famous fisherman whose soul was stolen by a mermaid. He got so obsessed with
that story is true. It was my grandpa, you guys.
And got banished to Saikiki Beach.
Yes, yes.
Oh man, getting banished to a beach sounds nice, actually.
Fake Hawaii's got fake Honolulu and fake Waikiki Beach. It's great. Waiting any longer.
That's what I'm trying to tell you,
Veronica,
it's not
sweetheart.
A fairy tale. It's true.
The read the between the lines.
That was my tutu, my grandpa.
She's going through a lot right now.
It all happened.
Yeah, what with not being allowed to drink and all.
Yeah. Jade didn't get it either. You know, we saw that little shocked face.
But the story didn't end there.
Yeah, but she knew that it was gonna come up.
Chased out of the village, the Kahuna's daughter, Leilani.
Listen, I've been in a classroom
and they had a kid
with a kid. Actually a teenager, a 16, 17-year-old, who would ask
came,
questions,
people started to forget
and
about
all,
Kainoa
every single one of those questions would
on
be
him, till one day,
the subject that was just
another
coming up in the lecture.
Struck, even more violent than the one that sent my grandfather to the bottom of the
like,
sea.
The how can you not know? How do you not know the rules of the format of a teacher's lecture? What the fuck?
I mean, having been a teacher for a number of years, that happens a lot, Joe. Not surprised to hear that.
They were nowhere to be found. But it was like every minute.
There's a number of times where you're just like, hey, maybe just like, you know, you be polite, you catch him, you know, outside of class, you don't embarrass somebody. Like, all right, I'm glad you're paying attention, but just when you got a question like that, maybe write it down on a piece of paper, give it a hot minute, because, you know, I'm getting there. Have you noticed that I seem to get there every day? Yeah! Next day, still asking the question.
They couldn't believe what they saw.
They need to know now.
She'd been living all alone for the last 10 years. But
everyone had turned blue!
Baby in his arms. And the baby...
Oh no, a goopy baby!
Not a goopy baby, just a wet one. It happens with babies.
I was gonna say, you know, what baby is not wet and goopy?
Talking about how he must have had a kid with the mermaid.
Ew, mermaid kid. It's one of those reverse mermaids, you know, with the tops of fish.
Wait, but that baby.
I remember somebody cut together that a sequence from one of the Star Trek movies where it's like,
would make you...
Kirk is at a computer and he goes, I don't like. He sees that picture.
My mother is a human
it's like,
being.
Would you rather
found her abandoned
a,
on the
a
beach
top girl
and
mermaid
her as his own.
Or a bottom girl mermaid? And he goes,
he
I don't like to lose.
A kid with a mermaid. That's just
I mean,
a
and so he hammers away at the keyboard. Fishermen. And there's a lot of close-up tense shots. And finally,
if that
on the screen appears
still out there
just
somewhere waiting
a fish
grandpa,
that can walk.
There's something
Kirk will do both.
Her.
He's fine.
Meet me on Saikiki Beach.
Beard of the face.
It's on the other
really
side.
Really depends
of the
on who you ask.
You can get there through the chapel at the back of the village.
Because, like, in the
church
like
has a secret forbidden door.
Linger.
We're gonna finally go through it.
Oh yeah.
Go to that beach.
Going. Well, no, it's we gotta go to the church. Then we can go to the beach. But first, yeah, we have Sparkly to get.
Through the church.
Because I believe I will need it later.
Of course, can't go around the church. There's church in the way.
Oh, gotta go to church to get to the secret beach, everybody.
Y'all need Jesus.
No, we need this chest.
Y'all need the luminary.
Man. $1,000?
Hey!
Oh, yeah. Wait, there's a cat! Oh, jeez, I'm... Alright, there we go. Sorry, little buddy. Cat. Yeah, and even Meps at us, alright.
Hey.
That's a great cat.
I get the feeling that maybe DQ8 probably had one of those workshops where they actually make those chests. It feels like a very Dragon Quest late era Dragon Quest sort of gag. And I don't know, you gotta get some special wood for him. And it's
it's Grandpa.
Really quick quest.
Hey!
Hey, Grampy Gramp.
Biting his lip more than ever. Okay. There's that pot. Alright.
Cool door.
I knew there was something to smash.
So what was Grandpa talking to that woman about? I saw something about brown bread.
I think he was doing weird Uncle Grandpa Scrooge flirting, you know, if we're being honest with ourselves. a gravestone. Oh, thank you for the follow, Maddie.
Hey.
Hey, Crimson Coral!
Oh, yeah.
My favorite kind.
Yeah. Let's see, is there anything else to smash out here? No, it's a treasure chest.
You passed by a jar. You passed by a jar by that door. Hey, another mini medal.
Nightbot timed out.
It's over. Yeah. Like, yeah. It was 5 seconds and it's done.
What happened? I completely missed it. I just...
Yeah, no, like, everything Lobster Boat has said from the very beginning?
Yeah,
what?
That's very strange.
Well, it's a five-second timeout, and the 5 seconds are over, right?
Just lying there, holding on to it.
Yeah, I guess there was a recently went into Nightbot and relaxed it a bit, so that's strange. But I know that Joe and Zell are mods, so you can unban if that happens, or unmute. Oh, hey! The Lover's Veil!
Look,
so
I'm sorry if I was kind of short with you back there, but it hasn't been easy for me and my ma. After Grandpa died,
so
they
this
let
is...
her go back to the village and marry a local guy.
So, Grampy Gramp is dead.
But it didn't stop folks talking. But she rose above it, turned it into that story show of hers, and now that's how she makes her living.
Go home, Nightbot. You are drunk.
Too. I hate that mermaid for what she's put us through. And I don't want my kids to suffer like
that. And then it came back.
Trying to make it up for it by advertising for you.
I'm sorry. He's playing all the Dragon Quest games and he's got friends getting in there. Let that be an end to it.
Hey, have you heard of my ongoing video LP of the Dragon Quest series with Scribbit Granola and various special guests?
No, tell me about that.
Check it out on this YouTube.
What are your feelings on Dragon Quest VI?
My feelings on Dragon Quest VI is that it has a very good beginning and middle.
I need to power through that one.
Fucking let me in that.
That's one I'm just doing post commentary on. I have to actually, wherever the last video ended up, I might have 5 more minutes done. I gotta psych myself up to do it, and then I gotta go back and, you know, cut out a lot of garbage. It's a whole process. Oh, hey, more stuff to break. The cannon lady. Oh man.
I love a cannon lady.
Sadly, she only makes cannons that can't actually fire projectiles. It's a whole thing.
That seems difficult. Oh, how would you even do that? Like, how is it a cannon?
Good question, but that's the gimmick. I think we just zoom to the strand. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Can't believe we're bringing news of a death at this strand. Dang.
Ooh, a sparkly. Ooh. Hang on, mermaid. I gotta tell you about a dead guy, but first I gotta get this sunbleached seashell.
You know, if you want, you could do a diversion from Dragon Quest VI to just play through Chroma Trigger.
Explain that as a side quest.
The five bed, three bath, that all bathrooms mm-hmm. had showers, and it had that weird thing in the attic with two roofs. Yeah.
Oh, should we lie to Michelle?
No, tell her the truth.
I have a really nice...
No.
She can move on with her life if you tell her the truth.
Right.
Okay. Decoration.
So, but here's the thing. It's dropped to 2725 now, but if Genesis moves in with us, and that's six.
That's the right thing to do.
All right, I'm doing it.
With including mm-hmm. Genesis.
So, trying to make Nightbot less of a ridiculous options. All right, let's crank this sucker up.
He said it was a vacuum.
All right, this should be fine. Hopefully that works. Hey.
Yeah. Aww. Michelle's so sad.
Yeah, and we actually have to swim or sail the whole way there. We can't just warp.
Yeah, you can't zoom with her.
Nope. Well, I mean, you know, she's a plot party. It's fine. She should be able to come with us. Oh, hey, metal.
That's true. I love that metal.
Yeah, if it was something lobster, if it was something like "Hey" with lots of Y's, it might have been dumb and thought you were spamming characters. I don't know. I increased the thresholds. It's dumb and I hate it. God.
Also,
lovely jubbly.
Oh, that's right. They just plot jump us there. I love it. Hey, let's go find that guy.
Let's find the young guy. Kiwi.
Find him. Let's go find that cat.
Let's bring him to his grandma.
Don't remember being.
Sorry. We're hiding. see if we can. Oh, jeez. It's nighttime. I think he's at his house. Hey, what are you doing?
Yeah, I know that.
Last one on your right when you're leaving the village. Alright. Should be this house. So, oh, Kai's house on the. Whoops. Look, Joe, as I told you, you know, what with my 190 whatever hours in this, there was a point I was just looping this regularly and had it well committed to memory. You know, I've taken some off the beaten path since then.
I'm all just right. Saying I would have made the same mistake.
Yeah. Hey, let's look for stuff to smash. There we go.
Naps. That's for chumps. That's your chump move.
Got it. Oh, actually, hey, we found poop. Smart. Great, poop.
Oh man.
You can do a lot of thing with poop. Let me ask you. You know, do you ever put like dog poop in a bag and put it on somebody's door and set it on fire, right at the doorstep, and knock it and run away?
No.
It's a lot of fun. I did it once when I was like a scumbag, like 13-year-old, and it is as funny as you think it is. I feel bad that I did it, but it was hilarious.
I mean, thing is, I didn't have access to a dog in my scumbag teen years, like early teens.
I never got to be a scumbag teen because I was terrified my mother would throw me out, so...
Alright,
come on, Kainui, let's get you to this mermaid lady.
Oh, this is rude. Thought you only found was your boat, nerd. This guy just can't catch a break, you know, because everybody thinks his mom's, you know, half mermaid.
Mm-hmm. Just the moistest baby.
He's eternally wet.
Eternally moistened towelette baby.
Sobered up.
Yeah, you know, they slept off the party. You know, they're back to their jobs.
You kind of had to sail away a bit.
Why have you brought me here?
Do we humans play down like this? Of course we do.
That voice! It's music to my ears! I feel like I could cry. Oh, darling, tell me, is it you? My one and only Kai?
The one and only Kai in existence?
Yeah, I'm Kai. Do I know you?
Aww.
Tell us, Pixel Moon.
Wow,
who is she?
Rip her heart out and stomp on her.
Oh, look at those artifacts.
You're a mermaid.
Oh, silly
me. Oh no, a mermaid.
Hi, we told you she was going to be a mermaid.
I don't know you. You're not.
He didn't want to believe it.
Boy.
Now he has to.
No, I'm not. The man you loved, he was my grandfather. He's not here anymore.
Aww.
But you know, if you're looking for a May December kind of thing,
you know, mermaids are. Well, they got a lot. They got a lot kick in them. I mean, I feel like she was old even with Grandpa.
Friendless on this cold and windswept shore.
She's eternally youthful.
Oh, how could I forget we
mermaids? This is so bittersweet. Aww.
Quick as a flash, a human life just ups and disappears. Without Kai, hours seem to pass too slowly to be true. But now I see cruel time was flowing faster.
She can be 500, so she just, you know, hung out on that island for like, what, 50 years?
Mm-hmm. What's she gonna do now?
Gonna beat
Thanks
yourself and die
for me. You've been a proper
out of grief
to trace my love across the sea until the bitter end. I said I would reward you, and I mean to pay that debt. You'll find your prize upon the selfsame island where we met.
Hey, prizes.
I'm sorry I can't come along and see you on your way.
Oh.
But now
at least
I'm
she's
here,
true to her
I
word.
Can't go back. I think I have to stay.
Oh, what? She's making the lantern home?
So, we asked earlier, kind of ironically, if she'd be happy with a corpse, and,
Yeah, you know. She's gonna be in the
that's
same place.
That's not you, that's not me.
It turns out, yes, in fact.
This will work for her, you know?
Why is she getting legs? Why is she acquiring legs?
It's, you've seen The Little Mermaid, at least some version
of it. Why wouldn't she acquire legs?
Not this version.
There's, you know, many different versions.
I waited for you so long, through sun and stormy weather. But now it's
disregard constabulary, acquire legs. That's how it works.
Oh, this is a suicide, great.
Yeah. Look, you know, game, you know, it gets dark, it gets light, it bounces all over.
This is, you know, the story of Romeo and Juliet was about how dumb teens are.
Yeah, no, teens are idiots, can confirm. Both having been a teen and, you know, been in a capacity working where I was around them a lot. Several times.
You've got your granddad's hands, you know. So soft, yet strong and honest. The hands of one who'd never, ever make a faithless promise.
Shell, what the fuck are you doing?
A mermaid who sets foot on land will perish in the brine. And that's all right.
So, okay, the mermaid rules here. Once you, you know, become a human, if you go in the salt water, that's it. So, you know, mermaids that become humans don't make pasta, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
Don't make bread.
There are no Italian mermaids, is what you're saying.
I mean, I should hope not.
I'm a mermaid. He's a man. There's no point asking.
Hey, you,
he was my one.
Just have an old swim around the Mediterranean there.
It's time to say goodbye.
My skull would be a shame if anything happened to it.
All right, here she goes, turning into sea
foam. Just turn into bubbles, little bubbles, tiny bubbles, right? They make us happy, right? Like the Don Ho song.
Sea foam.
Fake in real Hawaii, but with fake Hawaii, it's good. It's good.
I've seen her somewhere before. I don't like this.
Grandpa's cabin.
Well, and now you'll never see her again.
Sure about that? Cause, you know, he's saying,
she told us if she goes back in the water, you know, she dies forever. We saw her disappear.
Okay, but what if, no, okay, there's nothing in there. What else we got? We got bus, we got some supplies.
Just call it a baseball like everyone else.
Art was happening. We got some covered, right, on easel.
That's probably nothing.
Seems he was a bit of an impressionist.
Oh, hey, look at that. There she is. We saw her again.
Jade, are you okay?
What's this? A letter.
If we had only rummaged through Grandpa's things, we could have avoided this whole mess.
Dearest beloved,
this is so.
Ever since you saved me on the day of the great storm, the dream of one
just,
day.
Just, you know, always go through your relative stuff. That's what we've learned here.
But now I fear that dream is over. Forgive me, my darling, but I cannot keep my promise. Some years after my boat was burned and I was exiled to this beach, the fishing fleet was hit by another great storm. And many people lost their lives. The kahuna and his daughter Leilani's husband were among them. One night, not long afterward, I saw a woman standing on the cliffs. She had a baby in her arms. It was Leilani, the woman who was once to be my wife.
Really, just bum out area of town,
with
apparently.
Her father and husband gone, she had lost all hope and all reason. I called out to her, but in her grief, she could not hear me. Before my disbelieving eyes, she threw herself into the ocean. I tried to save them. I did everything I could, but only the baby survived.
Oh.
Kai? you're sure you're fine to row back home? You're not in any pain? I wish you'd let me keep you till you're fighting fit again.
Don't worry about me, Michelle.
Mispronouncing a word doesn't make it rhyme, Michelle.
I'm fitter than ever.
Again?
It's not how it works. That's some cheater rhyming.
Yeah, if that's the way your arm reacts, you should probably have it in a splint.
No, he's gonna be fine. He's gonna row himself back there. It's gonna be just fine.
I'll wait right here for you.
That's how the baby became soggy.
I was just gonna say, that baby doesn't look unusually wet, but...
I mean, you know, it's,
I'm sorry, Michelle.
Just wait. It's like a reverse Dracula, but just, once the sun comes down, it just starts exuding anymore. Just seawater. Everything.
I know, you fucking coward.
But him and the baby and the mermaid could go live under the sea. You put
a curse on me. People can take care of the baby. Go to the mermaid.
The baby's already wet.
They don't want what happened to me to happen to anybody else. You have to forgive them. They don't know you like I do.
They don't want what happened to me to happen to anybody else. What, find happiness?
No, nobody in fake Hawaii can find happiness. Just you live here, you work here, you die here. Just like you know, small town anywhere.
Still waiting for me to return.
That's what we've learned.
But it's really that sometimes life is contrived.
They're really not into anybody branching out.
But I want you to know one thing.
Also, he couldn't put that in a bottle?
I love you.
This is a fucking fantasy zone. He can wish upon a star and throw out a message in a bottle.
Yeah, fair enough.
Like, catch a fish, stick the note in there, tell the fish who you're looking for, and then throw it back. Like, that happens all the time.
Yo, fish, I know you know mermaids. Come on.
Yes. This is magic times. Everything's fucking magic.
I hated that mermaid for what she did to my grandfather.
I like how she didn't change her accessories at all in 50 years. That's like the epitome of not a phase.
Maybe, you know, when you live to be 500, you just kind of, you know, you pick your luck and you run with it, 'cause you got other things to worry about.
What does she have to worry about? She was able to wait for 50 years on that freaking island for a guy who never came back. All right, so now we have to go break the news to all the other mermaids, right?
Yup. I believe, yeah. Sail, receive a special treasure for the mermaids. Well, yeah, we're gonna do that. I'm gonna get a snack and maybe another can of seltzer. I'll be right back. It'll be great.
Neat.
Sometimes this game is good. This is not one of those times.
I don't remember this specific part of the mermaid. Like, I watched my boyfriend streamed this for a while. I couldn't catch all the streams, but I remember the mechanism for getting to the mermaids and the pearl, and that was pretty ridiculous.
I'll believe that.
Lobster boat, I think fishy strange is a little bit redundant.
Who calls it strange?
I referred to it as strange in the past. When I was in a work environment and had to be, like, extra particular about my words. Nobody understood what I was saying, so it worked.
I guess. I mean, that's not really a thing in my work environment, but okay.
I was working for a specific craft store at the time that tends to make you new for unfortunate things.
War profiteering, right. I forgot.
Yeah, there you go. I mean, over here we call it religious freedom, but you know.
Yeah. Definitely. Definitely not just plundering people who look different.
You know, though, the boss that I had at that particular store is, like, legitimately one of the best retail managers I have ever had, and he was complete and utter asshole, but in a way that a good, well-knit team worked well with him, and our store was one of the highest performing in the district or whatever, but...
Hey, I'm back.
Oh, hey. Man.
I got ramen chips, I got a whiskey, this can be great.
I used to work at the highest performing Domino's in Iceland, and it was so weird. It was like a just a direct pathway to success for like 3 or 4 managers while I was there. And then we got finally the one who could not succeed at that store, and he stayed. And that guy was just an utter shit, let me tell ya. He put me as close to a clopen as we get over here.
Ooh, hate those.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, what do you think our treasure is? Ooh, hey, shiny. Let's go get another shell.
Get a shiny.
We're at the beach. You go to the beach, you gotta pick up a shell and take it home. That's the rule.
Yeah.
Well, I thought you weren't able to take anything off the beaches in Hawaii.
Oh no, this is the strand. It's the beach where the ships just crash. This is different. Totally different.
Okay.
It's just a sandbar.
Also,
it's
you're thinking of Ayers Rock, which unfortunately sandbar, I cannot think of the real
Veronica
name of.
Somewhere else.
Yeah. All right, hey, treasure.
I worked for an office supply store in Arizona, and we referred to it as the punishment store. I went through 23 managers in 2 years, because our store was where the corporate folks sent the managers who fucked up, and if you continued to fuck up at our store, they sent you to the further store, and that's where they, like, piled on the stress until the manager would quit voluntarily, so they didn't have to fire anyone.
I just want you to know, Michelle's nickname is Shell.
Of course it is.
Shell.
Why would it be?
Hey, it's Shell.
You didn't see that before?
I'm gonna go back to good old rusty sword.
My sister-in-law's name is Michelle, and everyone called her Shelly.
No.
But not with it. They didn't change the S, which I got yelled at quite a bit 1 year for Christmas when I addressed her her presence to Shelly, Shelly. No, it's not. Still with the C.
I had a very fun time my first place I taught when I moved back to New Jersey, because I'd been in Maine for long enough that the, like, Quebecois, you know, pronunciations were in my head. And I had a kid, and I'll, you know, be respectful. I don't think it really matters, but hey, I'm, you know, vaguely nice. So I said the kid's name the way you would if it was, you know, like a Quebecois French thing, and he looked at me so weird. I was like, I'm sorry, could you say it? It was totally, like, the American, but specifically, like, New Jersey American speaking some French words way, and it was amazing.
So good.
Just putting exactly no English on it. So, hey, it's Mermaid Town.
Mermaid Town.
We're gonna be here a lot. There's a lot of mermaid stuff in this game we gotta do. Oh yeah.
We're just hanging out, having a good time.
Oh, no.
You ever just sit around and strum a harp for a while?
Eh, you know, every so often.
You ever just vibe?
Crivens, this place is a veritable paradise under the sea. Just when you think you've seen it all.
Homer was right, we should all live under the sea.
Down? It's always better down where it's wetter.
Thank you, Eric, for pointing out. Wait a second. What now?
Well, now we're here. I guess we can find out if that's
which is as much as we talk about it.
Yeah.
It's a very JoJo line.
Finding the orb is important.
You know, you can figure Jotaro would say that, like.
At least we don't magically develop mermaid tails, which is how some other franchises handle this.
Oh, you mean lesser ones.
I'm gonna spoil here. Don't worry, eventually we can turn into a little fishy.
Are we gonna have some fitty fun?
I think I remember that, actually. Yeah. I think I remember that being...
Which is good, because right now, as you can see, I'm very underwater gravity floaty if I try and do anything. Yeah.
It's my favorite kind of platforming.
Yeah, it's fun. So fun.
What? You mean I could just jump 3 times higher now? That's great.
We don't really jump any higher, it's just the
you
falling
just have
speed.
More hang time.
Yeah.
Oh, that's worse.
An extra pill. Oh, it's Michelle's house. She had her friend prepare for Kai, who never... Oh, they were gonna live under the sea.
Hey, free bed.
No, we can't actually stay in the bed. We can't even jump on
it.
We can't jump on it!
Jump on the bed.
I did. I jumped on the bed.
Yeah.
Little book.
Jump off the bed.
Oh, look. She even
love
wrote...
That
she wrote
a sea anemone there is like a lamp, but it's on the bed as opposed to being on a stand next to the bed.
It's fine. It's good. You know, bioluminescence.
Hi, my guy from Michelle.
Yeah,
Herbell.
So good old Michelle wrote an instructional informational pamphlet for Kai about, you know, adapting to living under the sea, you know? And
like
don't worry, she wrote it in rhyme, too.
And I think I like that she kept it here rather than keeping it with her to give to him when he came back so that he'd have it before he went under the sea.
Well, it's for when he got here, right? So that he could get used to things, you know? Because she's going to have to do, you know, mermaid stuff, and he'll be hanging out at the house, presumably, you know, until he gets settled and, you know, finds a job under the sea. So it's like, hey, you know, hang out, read this book, I'll tell you what you need to know. Walk around town.
Yeah, do you think that fisherman is a viable occupation down here?
It's funny you mention that, because let's just go over here. And yeah, it is, because look at this hot fella here, who looks like a hybrid of a Namekian and a Breath of Fire 2 dude.
That's Scarlet Jr. with fins.
Yeah, you fish for fish, why can't we fish for fish? Good question.
My only beef with this is that he's using that implement to do it.
Yeah, like, you'd think that there'd be something a little more efficient, because...
Yeah, like, you know, a harpoon or a net.
The fish aren't necessarily below him. The fish could be, like, to the sides or above or behind, so...
It feels cargo culty.
Circling back for a minute, the object I have wanted my entire life but never been able to find, even when I lived in Maine, and would go regularly to... We haven't saved in a while, we should do that. I'd regularly go to, antique stores and want... Harpoon gun. I would love to own a harpoon gun and just have it on my mantle, you know?
Oh, hell yeah.
Chekhov's harpoon gun, that's what I want.
I would like a banker's lamp.
I've had several. I was a bit younger, I guess I would, you know, just swipe one from one of the folks and give it to you, because they always had those growing up. And the desks, too, with the little pulley downy, you know? Where they got them from, I couldn't tell you, but we always had those growing up. So we're not good enough to swim up a bunch, so the mermaid's gonna, you know, just help us out here.
Aw, she's gonna give us a ride.
Yeah, later on we become a fish, we can swim up here. But right now, you know, we can jump off and... Yeah, it's a bit of a fall. You know, we're not swimming up there. So, we'll just ask her to take us up again. I mean, as Joe and I have experienced with our Dark Souls misadventures, you know, at least there wasn't an enormous ladder, you know. A snake eater ladder, as it were.
I welcome you to Nautica.
So I guess all the women look like human women with fish tails, and all the men look like, you know, fish heads.
Horrible goblins.
Zell, yeah. You're trying to say that this is some sort of society that's just all about the male gaze. Is that what you're trying to point out here?
I have a second sight.
Are you trying to say... You're trying to say that perhaps...
I'm not trying to say that. I'm just trying to say, you know, usually when there is gender dimorphism like this, the woman turns out sexier. That's it.
First, allow me to present
like,
the item.
There's something
that
to be said about like different cultures having different standards of beauty, but
oh, hey, it's the green orb.
Come on.
The orb you humans we need. Want one of them, right? The treasures of the world
above are marvelous. You know, Lobster, I never thought of it before that, you know, perhaps consider Queen Marina is, you know, the founder, CEO, inventor of the Nautica clothing line. Kindly, travelers, and may
it serve you well. I do not know of a single garment of theirs, but I'm pretty sure it does not look like that.
When I was a younger ghost, that was one of the, you know, you're a cool kid with money brands of clothes to wear.
I witnessed okay. The whole story.
You know, it was up there with your Tommy Hilfigers. It breaks my heart. And your Abercrombie and Fitches. Abercrombie and Fitch, you know that one?
But while the kinda
holds,
such romances are blighted.
The Krabby and Fish and the between
fizzles unrequited. I think that would be abalone and fish in this universe. Thank you very much. To remedy this
curse. Alas, my every effort ends in failure or worse. You humans cannot help but seem a fragile kind to we. Who live 500 years and more down here beneath the sea.
Why does everybody have to rhyme?
The flame of human life burns short.
Well,
it burns
because
so bright.
It's all,
you never cease to struggle.
Shakespearean.
No, you push, you strive, you fight.
Even in that town where everyone speaks
so
in haiku.
Your kind admire our kind, but we admire in turn. It is the world tree's will
that
from each other we should
learn. I didn't notice that the ghost will pan if I just lean in. If I lean in real close, it'll start zooming in too. That's fun. I can abuse that.
I pray that in their next lives they may stay that way forever.
I notice a little bend when I'm, you know, being gross and popping my neck because, you know, I'm all jacked up. But,
yeah, I was wondering about that.
Yeah, if I'm just, you know, stretching my neck, he'll, you know, follow with me.
I just want to know why he keeps winking at me.
So because I wear glasses, my left eye is more blocked off by the light, so it seems to not catch that one a bunch, but my right one doesn't have the lens flare on it. If I take my glasses off, it's less of a blinker, but I also can't read things because I have terrible vision.
That's fair.
It's like being an indoor kid that played a bunch of video games and, you know, computer games and read a lot of books as a child. Kind of screwed my eyes up. Oops.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
You couldn't just pretend that you're Irish?
No. I mean, I think I am from my mother's side, but, like, that's one of those. It's like, nobody knows where they are. What do we need? Do we require counsel? Yeah, tell me something. Go to the west. Got it. Oh, all right. Hey, we're gonna go meet the metal man.
A metal man?
The metal man wants all these mini metals.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. So, all right. We're gonna go to the whales.
Love to see what we can get for those metals.
Once again, to the strand.
Oh, man. The new Kirby looks really good.
I don't know. Car Eater Kirby's, it's a bit much for me. It made me uncomfortable to see. All right?
Listen, that's just That's just you.
It is.
Like, I don't... Listen, people getting weird about Kirby living his best life and acquiring a car...
Eating a car.
Yeah.
I enjoy learning about everything that came out on the Nintendo Direct via all of the memes making fun of it later, so the fact that there's... It took me a while to figure out what was going on with Kirby swallowing cars like he's been.
I was watching it because, you know, A, I had nothing better to do, and B, I was hoping maybe we'd finally get updates about Dragon Quest III, you know, and that Unreal Engine that Octopath and everything's in now. Or that we'd have an update about Dragon Quest X Offline Edition, which, you know, didn't happen. But yeah, the Kirby was a bit, ooh boy.
It's called Mouthful Mode.
Yeah, it is called Mouthful Mode. Face your inner
vortex.
Because
his mouth is so full.
It's full of a lot of stuff, yeah.
It's so full with
yes,
an entire
no
old car.
And for no other reason.
It's full of an entire vending machine.
Okay, I will admit, I did like Vending Machine Kirby. Vending Machine Kirby I liked a lot. I thought he was ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. How about Traffic Cone Kirby?
That one was alright.
Mm-hmm. I feel like... but, like... The people who are astounding it out as some weird body horror... Like... It's just Kirby being Kirby, you know? It's just part of how he is.
I feel like Kirby's...
I did see somebody say that they saw that this particular designer who was like a vor fetishist was working on the Kirby games again. I'm like, have you not paid attention to any Kirby game ever? That's the only... Yes, exactly, Jetpack Jesus. Like, that's all Kirby's ever been.
Like, if you want to be weird about it, that's on you. I'm just thinking back on when Kirby got turned into a bit of yarn and put into, like, a quilt work, a patchwork sort of land, and he said that it said, like, pants.
I love that game so much. I would get caught in the loop. Playing the game would make me want to knit, and knitting would make me want to play the game.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that Dracky lady.
Yep. It's got a zombie of zombie student. You know, there's a lot here.
Mm-hmm.
We don't discriminate in this school.
This is a very Cromarty sort of feel. You remember that episode?
Which one? There's so many. We're just...
The one where they're girls?
I mean, I was just saying in general, just, you know, with Freddy and, you know, the animals and all that. That was more where I was going with that.
Freddy?
Freddy Mercury in every episode. He's like, oh, it's Freddy. Rides a horse everywhere. Why wouldn't he?
And there's a in the girl episode, there's a girl Freddy, and it's just like him in his outfit from the video to I Want to Break Free.
Now, to your lesson. May you have a maximally fruitful day on your journey to become miniature ladies.
Miniature
par
ladies
excellence.
Par excellence. So this
all
being a French school,
now?
Is that a Marmite reference?
Look, this is just where women in this universe go to learn a little bit about culture and stuff, and also just tear ass around the world to hunt mini metals that their principal just, you know, puts places for reasons.
Ladylike reasons.
Yeah, it is very ladylike.
Mm-hmm. So it's Mr. Metal.
Mm-hmm.
It is not so often that we receive les visiteurs. It is an anomaly common occurrence, in fact.
Wait, if you don't get visitors, then how do you get new students?
People get sent. It's okay. It's like the scam of, you know, the Ivy League, where, you know, you get in and then your kids get in. That's all it is. Since we did all the quests, we won't learn, but we do find out that Jade's mom went here, and maybe she was in love with another student.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
That's intrigue.
Where in France is this, where is France in this universe? Located pretty much just in this school, Jetpack.
You will see. Yeah, you're in it. You better start believing in fantasy, France. You're in it.
All right, we better blend in. All right, hang on. Bum, 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 bum,
bum, bum. Does that mean new outfits?
Oh yeah.
Ooh, are we doing all schoolgirls all the time?
Oh, you better believe it.
Oh, it's time for Veronica to put on her best outfit.
Yep. Geez, Gorf, what we got for you? Nothing really says school. Just
what about fugitive?
I mean, this is pretty plain, you know. That's
Cobblestone's finest, yeah.
School adjacent.
Sure.
Can run with this one. Let's see. Yeah, yes. Sadly, we don't have her quest. This is my favorite schoolgirl. It's, you know, the bad girl of the school. She took one of the instructor's whips and broke it, and we had to go make a whip to replace it. But, you know, she's just got a power squat going on. You know, she's great.
Yeah,
I love
she's
Zazzy.
A Yankee, definitely.
Yeah, Zazzy's here to cause some trouble. Yes, an entire European nation at this time of the year in this anime game located entirely in a school building. I don't know what's hard to understand about that.
Mm-hmm. And there's just grass and growth inside.
How big do you think France is? Why wouldn't it fit in just in a school building?
Yeah, how big could France possibly be, Jetpack? It's like a mile square, you know?
It's not like there's several different nationalities within France.
Monoculture. French. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, there you are. Now, you must allow me
what's
to
that?
Introduce
the
myself.
The Minor Britons?
I am Maxime Medaguer. And this is my humble
establishment. Oh, he's named for the Maxi Medal.
There you go.
Maître de médailles, a school in which miniature ladies bloom into beautiful full-grown flowers. As part of the education, we
he talks real slow,
our pupils to journey through all the lands of Edrea, and to gather the maximum number of mini-medals they can find.
Joe, have you noticed that he likes to use maximum and minimum a whole lot and variants on that? Have you noticed that? Did you get that about him? And acquire at least a minimum of, Jetpack, I think it's just French. I don't think he's drunk.
Why does one preclude the other? I think you have to be... You know,
the most
at least one of those in this situation.
Detector of my career before me. However, there is one miniature problem. The academy is for young girls and young girls alone. Sadly, I cannot offer you a place
what
here.
We wear a cool
but
hat.
Does this mean I will allow such potential maximal to remain untapped? No! By the power vested in me, I hereby enroll you as an honorary
everybody, we're an honorary girl. All right.
Couldn't we just have enrolled Veronica?
Shut up. We're the hero. It needs to be us.
Listen, isn't one of her like goals to age herself back up? She wants to be maximum, and she's currently minimum, so she's perfect here.
This is so true.
Good point.
A minuscule
66 medals. Oh boy. Yeah, we can get some later. I don't think there's anything we really need right now. So the reason once you get all the medals, right, to keep finding them, is we can just keep getting these MacGuffins, which we could also get at the casinos. Now, you say, hey, why would you want to restore all magic just in one go? Well, hey, Veronica, or win the game button, every once in a blue moon, you gotta have her do her explosion more than once. So this expedites the process. And also through, you know, reasons, you can duplicate items as the gameplay mechanic, which, you know, we'll do eventually.
It's very important.
Yeah. All right. Now we gotta go talk to somebody. Look at this lovely chalk drawing.
Yeah. It's really nice.
The eerie. Hmm. A mean bird that likes to take. Yeah, I think we have to go to this place, see what's happening.
Mm-hmm. By the way, that teacher lady had a cool hat.
I have one, you know, hanging up right next to me on back of my door. You know, I could put mine on, but you know, you wouldn't see it on the ghost. If I get fancy enough, I guess I could, you know, give my ghost a mortarboard.
You totally should. In remembrance of your teaching career.
Ah, yes. You know, I think, Jetpack, that actually this bird, oddly enough, has human-esque eyes. It's a little weird. And I did the forge again by accident. We don't want to make anything. Ooh, a metal slime. Oh, it's metal slime knight. Different. Not worth our time. Alright, what's the... up, around, okay. Bomberman can't go up the stairs. You gotta leave him behind.
Aww.
It's a shame.
That kitty can totally
climb those stairs.
He's a good kitty, he just has problems, you know?
It's with heights, that's all.
The slow, wobbly, but steady walk, just getting up.
Just wobbles his little kitty butt.
Hey, guess what, we just bring it right back.
Either that or he's like my cat, who's apparently going blind, and once she gets up somewhere, she can't figure out how to get down again.
Oh no.
Oh no. Oh. Poor girl.
Eh, she's 15. It happens.
Alright, you know, you had a good run, friend, I guess. Speaking of friends, hey! It's one of our invisible boys.
So, the Icelandic word for lion is ljón, and my sister, she basically accepted a cat that was about to lose his own to, like, just a move. And his name was Leonatan, and he was a very experienced sort of cat, very good at being a cat, knew exactly who to seek out for some pets.
Aww.
But also, he was blind as fuck. And also cross-eyed, so like...
Oh no.
He was just way too cute.
Peck's cat doesn't use the stairs, just jumps up the side. Yeah, at my old house, you know, I had the little inclining ramp from where the banister stuff was, and the banister was not there, but Tuna loved to just run up it.
Aww.
He raced me up at night, it was great. Man, you can't read a sign while standing behind it? That's ridiculous. I refuse to read that sign.
I like this gag. It's dumb, and I appreciate it. What I don't like is that one sign from, I think, 4 or 5 that you only can read from behind it?
Oh, yeah. 4. Well, that's because there's a secret message.
Ooh. Man.
There's, I think it's in here, there is a sign during one of the quests that you need to read. From behind, ooh.
Oh look, a fireplace.
Yeah,
bonfire.
Yeah. You know, if you want to fight battles, we just, we need this robot. We gotta uses steam-powered pneumatic legs. I don't know how to do stuff.
An exoskeleton.
Yeah, rotten exoskeleton. Lego my egg-ego.
Why do you want to be in there? It's rotten.
Yeah, what do you think it smells
stinky.
Like?
Now you've become stinky.
I mean, who among us hasn't been, just in a stinky metal coffin?
Me?
Oh, well.
I haven't.
Didn't know
about you, but
I have
not.
Sorry, that's the sort of life you've lived, you know?
Listen, that's an experience that I am glad to be without.
No, we can't cheese it. Curses.
Cusses.
That's my way nervous.
You know, I recently got reminded of the fact that Idolmaster has a love song to
Cave, that's
the
right.
To the hamburger.
Speaking of hamburgers, I was reminded the other night of when Alex Hirsch was calling into that Rudy Giuliani election fraud hotline as various Gravity Falls characters, and the one of him as Seuss claiming that he saw the Hamburglar messing with ballot boxes, I love so much.
Yeah. That's so great. The only pranks that I've seen of Rudy Giuliani is like NEAS calling into his radio type show and just really hammering home the notion that he he married his cousin, which is apparently a real thing.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. I've met several people and went to school with people who, you know, married their cousin or parents were cousins. It's, you know, it happens. All right. What if we got rid of the egg and rode around on a skeleton?
Yes. Yes. Very yes.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
I'm here for this. This is what I need in my life. I need a demon skeleton.
Well, they can walk up walls there, you know?
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's very important.
Right. Sprinting! So they have an alternate version of this area that you see later, where it's slightly different, and they got dragons you can beat up and ride around on. So it's a little bit less of this. So, hey, giant crystal.
I love his little legs skittering around. Ah, that's incredible. It's everything I need.
Just, you know, a busy boy running around, having a good time.
Yeah, just making his way downtown. This is soothing for the soul.
Sadly, we must leave our good friend behind.
Oh no!
And it's funny too that like you can't climb a ledge while mounted. It's like, but this guy climbs ledges. This is what he does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it doesn't have the little feet on it.
Jetpack? I think it's just, you know, a demon skeleton. No big.
Yeah. It's all Damon left a skelly.
Ah!
You got another thing coming.
Jade, just take these idiots out.
Can't believe there's three of them.
Oh, it's your Veronica's already super angry.
She's just pepped.
Yeah, we don't need to regenerate. Let's just have her explode, you know?
Yeah. That's a true fact.
Veronica wins again!
I'm back, and I completely agree with True Facts.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're allowed to fuck up in your 20s. Yeah.
Definitely. Oh, yeah, you can hear that part. All right.
Hey, we got another orb. The silver one.
Hey. Does it have any memories in it?
No, but what do we got right now? We got the red, the yellow, the green, the silver. Two more orbs to go.
Two more orbs.
Yeah.
Making progress.
Yes, yes, progressive orbs. Let's get out of here. Do we have a goal? I don't think we have a goal. I only go back to France.
Yeah, weren't you supposed to find a proper young lady to give you the silver orb or green orb?
I don't really have enough stream emotes that I have an orb, but I have that.
Hey, that's, you know, orb-esque.
A white orb.
Aha. Alright.
Let's see here. I think we got...
There we go. Ah, that's where we want to
go. Oh, one of these.
Alright, I think we want to book it to the north now. Yeah.
What?
So how do you pronounce the name of the world tree? Because there is a correct pronunciation that I've heard, and there's also a ridiculous pronunciation.
I mean, I just have always said Yggdrasil.
That's the correct one.
Yeah. What have you heard?
Yggdrasil?
Yeah, I've heard that every so often, you know.
Well,
I guess.
I mean... I can answer the question posed. For one, you don't just say Yggdrasil, you say Askur Yggdrasils.
Oh, really?
Because it's an ash, and you gotta recognize that fact.
Look, Joe, my knowledge comes from playing Faxanadu and this, you know, the Eddas and Sagas of the Norsemen that I got on the shelf behind me, alright? You're asking a lot of me with that one. I'm a stupid, stupid man.
All right. But, you know, question came up. I had to answer it.
Otter shingles. Whole group of enemies was an otter shingles.
Jeez, it's very, very snowy. Wonder why. Wonder where we're going. What fake nation?
Yeah. Are we up north?
This is clearly Finland. Gotta watch out for any fake Kalevalas. You know, gotta drop a Sampo. You ever think about the Sampo? That's fucked up.
Can't say I do.
Yeah, not.
I think
not...
it's like a pepper mill, except it spits out infinite gold. Yeah, and it's made of gold.
It's funny you're talking about gold. Wonder if that's gonna be a theme eventually. We're gonna have to deal with somebody's obsession with gold.
Is there any in these there hills?
There's some hills and there's some gold, you know? Hey, look, it's Yggdrasil, off in the distance.
Hey. And a pillar of light.
Yeah, you know, we gotta play some mermaid harp, do a little warping, it's fine.
Yeah.
It's the old undersea highway.
Wait a minute, weren't you just there?
You can't get through. You need to warp. Yes.
Oh, I get it.
Niflheim.
Yeah, Midge, always is just kind of Sniffleheim. And fair enough.
Well, see...
Here we are.
When an F comes before an L, that means that it becomes a P. So it's Sniffleheim.
It's a fair wee while since I've visited, but it warms my heart to be back.
clearly.
The language hour with Jules.
That must be about the only thing that is warm around here. Let's hurry up and get inside before we all freeze to death.
Aww. Look at Veronica go.
How are you gonna get inside, Veronica? Didn't you see all that ice?
She's kind of a powerful wizard. The
gates are covered. You're right. She should be able to melt it with her explosive fire attacks, shouldn't she?
Yeah.
Hmm. Interesting.
Come on, wizard. Do your wizardly duties.
You're a wizard. Do the wizard thing.
How strange.
You're a fucking wizard. Still, it's like...
I suppose it's only natural that... Alright, I gotta take care of some real-world stuff, so I will be back momentarily.
Do it, do it.
You ever play, like, an FPS from 1998 and you look at a door and you take out your rocket launcher and you fire it at the door and the door is fine?
Yeah, it's always a little, a bummer.
Mm-hmm.
They've always made sure to keep the main gate free.
Why they
frost,
don't give you rocket launchers
even in the
anymore?
Dead of winter.
So, what are we supposed to do? There's an orb in there we need to get to.
We're on an orb hunt,
well,
Gramps.
If we can't go
come
in
on.
The front door, we'll just have to head round the back.
Brilliant idea. There's always a back door, right?
I thought this was the back door.
Look, I've seen war games. There's a back door and everything. We also need to take a nap. Veronica can't get angry yet.
Oh, look, a fire. I wonder if we could use that.
We're able to light a fire. Yeah, maybe we could, like, transport that fire someplace.
Yeah, to someplace that's that is cold and needs to be warm.
Hey, there's a lock on my mini-map. Hey, some bunnies. Hello, bunnies.
You know, people talk shit about the guys who talk about ludonarrative narrative dissonance, but this is exactly it.
All right. So now, if I remember right, we can get the key to this door, but we got to go back to France.
All right.
It's a lot of going back to France. Did you find the back door, Santa? We gotta go to France, and then we gotta go to Thailand, I think. It's, you know, there's a lot going on here. Maybe Cambodia? Let's say Cambodia. That's more appropriate to, you know, France and colonization.
Man.
Yeah, just.
You ever just ride around on your giant cat?
Yeah, I mean it's fun, you know.
Like IRL.
No, he's not that big. Tuna is quite big though. I think I would hurt him if I tried to ride on him. I have used him as a pillow and a leg rest though. I can, you know, confirm that.
Oh, how polite of him.
Yeah. You know, he's all right.
Wait a minute. Hi-ya! That guy. Whoopee! He's an encounter.
Everything's a fuck guy. There's no guys there. Goodness. Get rid of him.
Yeah, I guess he did.
So we're taking a slight detour to tag this bonfire, because we might need a warp later. Now we can go to the town.
Yeah. Get in that town.
I'ma tryin'. Yeah, Jetpack, it is kind of a Souls game in this point that every time you tag a bonfire, it's a warp point!
Just makes sense, though.
Yeah.
I mean, like, what were save points except just places to plop down your tent? Oh, man. Now, are those tiki torches?
Out of the way, drongos. Some of us have got sights to see.
I see this place is still full of friendly visitors.
It's actually Australia.
We passed through. No, it is. It's southeast. It's a Southeast Asian country, which because there's Australian tourists.
The
old now what? Brings good get it? To all who lay eyes upon it.
Well, if they believe that kind of rubbish, I'm guessing you didn't find out much of any use.
Aye, that's right, laddie. Not a sausage.
You ever think about how the boss theme in Blue Dragon was sung by the guy from Deep Purple?
No, I haven't actually. I do think about Deep Purple a lot. You know, Perfect Strangers is a good song. You know,
we'll have to make Bananas also a good song. The mountain to get there.
I used to like to put Perfect Strangers on the jukebox at the bar that I used to work at, and just tell somebody, "Hey, this song's your personal theme." Just whoever you know, I knew that was there. It amused me, that's all that matters. Ugh, the ruins. Jeez.
It's a good move.
You find somebody that you don't know, or you barely know, and you dedicate a song to them.
Yeah. Because you're perfect strangers.
Yeah. So guess what? We're going to be running up and down stairs a lot.
Good. Yes. That's what I want. Mother. That's the good content I crave.
You like back and forthy fetch and escort quests, right?
Doesn't it just break your heart? Yeah, I'm definitely into those. Poor thing's lost her parents. Actually, I really do like those if they're sweetie. Written right.
It's all right. We'll help you find them. Now,
but yeah, one thing name? I've heard is a good move to do in bars Dora. Is like put on If I Were
my
a Rich Man.
Dora. Can you hear with my and mother and father?
Then just go, like, after the divvy-divvies, do a hey. And see when everybody joins in.
To make them rich, and then they just went. please help me.
Dara's parents are dead.
No, they're not dead. They just went to this mural to get rich, and for some reason they didn't show back up. Why would you say they're dead? Find out
where they've gone. Well, I guess it's time to go exploring.
I'll take the town. Dora, you search the ruins, okay? How can you say that? Look at this poor little creature. Have you got a stone for a heart or something?
Please.
Silvando, you're so extremely good.
Oh, there, little one. We'll find out where they've gone. Don't you worry.
He is the gallant knight. I'll take the I wish he'd wear his hat more. Just saying. Okay? Got a great hat with that outfit.
Yeah, he should. You wouldn't let me down. But, you know, it does obscure his eyebrows, which are important.
I suppose. I also like that he's just wearing denim.
What, like?
Yeah, he's had like some jeans on, you know?
Canadian tux?
Yeah, well, I mean, no, because he had a leather jerkin. Oh, they're running.
Gotta run. Around.
I'm running around. There's a treasure chest, though. We can get that. Mm-hmm. Look, one of our friends is here.
Look at this temple.
Hey, $500.
Oh, man, look at that friend. I love those ghosts. I have no idea where they came from.
Talkington?
Yeah, sure. They're not much for talking, though.
You came for a look at the mural.
Some of them do, just
too,
most of
huh?
them don't.
Well, here it is.
Eh. Mural of a lady with red hair and a purple dress.
It is pretty impressive. I still don't believe all that stuff about it being lucky, though.
Yeah?
She's not exactly in the best condition.
Wait a minute.
But yes, what? You're right. She's beautiful.
What is that gash?
It's, you know, just, it's a ruin, you know, just... Cement, rock, it all cracks
What's
after a while.
What's that around her neck? It looks like some kind of strange key.
I see what you're looking at, Serena.
Not just any old strange key. Serena, that's the magic key. I'm sure of it.
The magic key?
That's the one that gets you into cells, your stomach, right? Veronica?
No, that would be the, depending upon the game, right, the jailer's key or the ultimate key.
No,
the magic key
not.
Is just your red door
Maybe
key.
Maybe if you weren't so clearly distracted by this impressive lady here, you'd realize that didn't sound anything like my tummy rumbling.
Oh, shut up, you little brat.
He's shining.
Impressive. Is it just gonna pop out?
There she blows, and just like she looked in my dreams too.
Who are
these
people?
Little beauty's gonna make old Bazza rich. Hey, there's plenty of room for everybody to look, you know.
Have you ever heard of any? Australian
spiky,
ever saying the phrase,
know,
there she blows?
We deserve a chance to get rich,
no,
too.
Can't say I have. But, you know, I also don't know, I only know a handful of Australians, and none of them work in the maritime industry, so who could say, really?
Yeah, give someone else a chance to be happy, why don't ya? I think we should probably leave, don't you? Wow. I was pretty keen to see the mural, but clearly not as keen as some.
What is that to?
Is there something else worrying you?
What is it, silent protagonist? Huh. What's the problem?
So you're looking for this kid's parents, huh?
Care to share?
Well, we got nothing better to do. Let's see what we can find.
There you are, my trusty sidekick!
Hey, Sylvanda, what did you find?
Alas, I found no sign of the missing persons in town. Did you have any
luck here?
Best
character.
It is a puzzling mystery indeed. Ah, but I am forgetting our young client. A detective cannot leave a child in distress. Come, we must find her.
Fantastic. But hey, that's for next time. I'm gonna have my birthday dinner. It's gonna be great.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, let's, seen kids? Yeah, that's ultimately what's happening. And we'll figure that out.
Yeah.
So, let's
see
what
great.
We can do. Hang on, do we have... Yeah, why not? Bam, 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 bam. Send everybody to Doc. He's playing Resident Evil 4 challenge in modes with the old HD texture pack and the pro difficulty, the hard one. Have fun with that.
Yeah. And I'm gonna go to sleep.
Do it. See you, Joe.